del actual régimen de gobierno y la autoridad de Hugo Rafael Saldría.
Todo el mundo lo sabe, nosotros veníamos diciendo, tenemos documentos con 19 pasos de un golpe de Estado.
Petrocolonialism was installed in Venezuela and dominated our politics, our culture, and our economy.
Colonia política y luego colonia cultural, colonia económica.
With the oil industry under state control, Mr. Chavez bears responsibility for how it is run. At a first glance, the numbers do not look encouraging. Experts say production has dropped about a third since he came to office, robbing the country of the full financial benefit that could have accrued in 2008 when global oil prices peaked around $140 a barrel. Venezuelan oil analyst Juan Carlos Sosa says the government has diverted funds from oil infrastructure in order to sustain ever more expensive socialist initiatives.
To get back to the 1998 level of production, Venezuela would need to invest $10 to $12 billion a year for the next 10 years to upgrade its petroleum operations. This is not being done, so the situation is critical.
To make matters worse, according to Sosa, the government has fired thousands of technicians from the state-owned oil company PDVSA and replaced them with workers whose primary qualification is their loyalty to President Chavez. And he notes a significant portion of Venezuela's dwindling oil production is donated to Cuba and other leftist-led countries.
Cuba receives more than 100,000 barrels of Venezuelan oil per day without paying anything. Instead, Cuba provides medical services, sports training, and other esoteric assistance. It's an ideological arrangement. But PDVSA suffers because it could be selling that oil to the United States for hard currency.
Pero la empresa sufre muchísimo económicamente porque esos 110,000 barriles se los podría estar vendiendo a Estados Unidos y facturando en dólares y recibiendo el dinero en dólares.
El
President Chavez scoffs at the criticism, noting that Venezuela has signed accords with China and other nations that will yield tens of billions of dollars of investment in oil infrastructure. Far from declining further, he predicts production will double.
In just a few years, we will be producing 5 million barrels a day, then 6 million barrels a day.
Ordinary Venezuelans have mixed feelings about how their nation's oil wealth is managed. This man appreciates cheap domestic gasoline sold at pennies per liter, but adds,
on the other hand, if the price of gasoline were higher, maybe there would be more funds for roads and other projects.
But this worker at a PDVSA-run textile shop sees nothing but positives.
PDVSA used to just pump oil to support the wealthy. Now, oil is used for healthcare, nutrition, education, and jobs. We have this center thanks to PDVSA. It finances everything. PDVSA is everywhere helping the people. Like the president says, PDVSA now belongs to the people.
Venezuelan economist Orlando Ochoa says nationalistic slogans and socialistic rhetoric cannot disguise what he sees as a simple truth, that the Chavez model is unsustainable.
Oil prices for the first 6 months of the year are roughly what they were in the year 2006, a boom year for Venezuela. But now that revenue is not enough for the government, which has boosted domestic spending by subsidizing food and taking over private enterprises. The government also distributes much aid abroad. In total, its obligations exceed its revenues, and this has led to higher budget deficits.
But Ochoa admits that continued oil revenues, even if insufficient to cover mounting government expenditures, will allow President Chavez to put off any day of reckoning that may loom ahead. Michael Bowman, VOA News.